Welcome to the Brewhouse Gallery. I'm Wayne, I'm your host for the evening. Welcome. We do our All Arts Open Mic every Thursday. We've got comedy, poetry, music, spoken word. Whatever people want to do, we let them come out and do it. Got some great entertainers tonight. Some new folks, some old folks, some folks that haven't been here in a while, some folks that come every week and we can't get rid of them no matter what. But they're good. Who has never been here before?
Well,
wow. How'd you guys hear about us? Just shout out.
Internet.
Internet? Like our website? Not our website. Our website's down right now, but we're working on it.
Openmics.org or something like that.
Yeah. South Florida. Cool. Awesome. Awesome.
Old surfers.
Old surfers. What old surfers?
His dad.
Dad's not that old.
Well,
I love your dad. I love Mike. By the way, get over from Mike. He's our sound guy. He makes everything. Every Thursday, he makes everybody sound good. Who else? Where's my other new folks? How'd you guys hear about us? Yeah, go ahead. Anyway.
We're related.
You're related?
Yeah.
That's awesome. Big family. I like that. Well, welcome. We do this every Thursday. The only Thursday we don't have open mic is on Thanksgiving Day. That's it. And then the only other time we never had it was when the hurricane knocked out our power last year. But that's it. It's the only event that we actually like have the most times here. If you guys are looking for food tonight, you'll see some people wandering around. You can order from the bar and Brick and Barrel, which is an amazing restaurant in our plaza. We have a deal worked out with them. You order from the bar, they bring it right to your table. It's awesome. That being said, make sure you include some tip if you have a little cash. Throw a couple bucks on your stand because the delivery guy doesn't get tipped out at the end of the night when you pay the bar. The bartenders do. And also be very generous with our bartenders, especially coming to the holidays, folks. We have amazing bartenders. Every weekend we have live music, Friday, Saturday. Sundays we rotate events. If you guys are into blues, every other Sunday we have our open blues jam here. So check out our Facebook, our website. If you also want to get on the mailing list for both of our venues, we have next door the Kelsey Theater. We bring in national bands, plays, musical acts. We're the only ones in Palm Beach County doing the Rocky Horror Picture Show. All sorts of cool stuff. Go to the KelseyTheater.com, sign up for our mailing list. We only send one email a week just telling you what's happening. It's the best way to know what's going on at both venues since AJ, who's the owner, owns both things. Next Thursday, not only are we doing our open mic, but from 6 to 8, we'll be doing our artist reception. We call it artist opening. Basically, every 90 days, we rotate the art. We do not charge a commission for the art to be here. The artist rent their space on the wall for 90 days so that this way they could be working artists that actually make money as opposed to most galleries where you pay 50 or 60% commission. They just pay a minimal fee, and usually if they sell like a half of a painting or like one, it covers their whole 3 months. Next week, a lot of our artists will be here. And we'll do a little reception with them where you can meet them, hear about their art. We do like a little open mic thing for them for about 10 minutes before where they all come up and they'll be like, hey, I'm Bob. These are my paintings. This is my inspiration. And they kind of explain their stuff. And excuse me, that's it. I'm going to be gone for about a month, just so you guys know. Don't panic. Rach, who's been here the last few weeks while I was out? John and Rachel. John Hine and Rachel Blavatnik, they'll be running the open mic for the month of January. I'm going to have some surgery. Got to be off my feet for about... I got a broken mic stand, I think. What did I do, Mike? I broke the stand. So I'll be gone for about a month, but we got some great people that will be running the open mic, so make sure you still support it, and then I'll be back the first week of February. That being said, I want to bring up our first performer. Please welcome Dr. Peggy.
Never been here so early, and I always close the show. Now I'm opening the show.
still need to clean off the mic. Even though I'm the first one to use it. Too many years as a doctor. So I see some new faces, so let me just properly introduce myself. I am Peggy K. Ching, MD, FACS. Did you catch all of that?
What?
Alphabet soup.
Peggy K. Ching, MD, FACS. That's right. I have more initials in my name than the Chinese have alphabet. Chinese have no alphabet. It's a joke. And I'll tell you why Asians are smart. It's a straight black hair. It protects the brain from damage of cosmic rays. Yeah, right. You believe everything a doctor tells you? We have another Asian here. Neither of us have black hair. Neither of us are too smart here. Yeah. So the MD in my name, in my family, actually stands for Mommy Dearest. No wire coat hangers ever. And when I graduated from medical school, not too many women become surgeons. So when I finished my training as a surgeon, the American College of Surgeons, ACS, make me one of their fellows. FACS stands for Fellow of American College of Surgeons. I'm a fellow.
Good fellow.
Yeah. Didn't even need a sex change. For what they put me through, I've grown a set of balls. But look at me. I turned prematurely gray. Side effects of growing balls. I was a straight A student. The typical, you know, Asian straight A student. I graduated college summa cum laude. And I'm a board certified plastic surgeon. Finally, this time, I'm finally the woman I always dreamt to be. A ditzy blonde. And I'm having so much more fun. So, every time I come up to do open mic, I feel like a minority. Yeah. I have a decent day job. And my parents, like typical immigrant, first generation. Actually, I came with them. But as all immigrant family, they put all their hopes and dreams in their children. And I am their liberated overachiever version of our son, the doctor. Actually, they had in mind for me to grow up to marry a doctor. And I didn't feel attractive enough to lure a doctor. But I thought I was a little bit smart, so I thought, hey, I'll just grow up and be a doctor. Well, turns out it's easier to be a doctor than to be married to one. Just ask any of my ex-husbands. My last ex-husband, before we were divorced, I was like his Capital One, what's in your wallet? With me in his pocket, he needs no cash, no credit, no job. And by the time he finished with me, spend my money, ruin my credit. Now, my FICO score is as high as my cholesterol score. And the identity thieves got me on the no steal list. Please, take my identity. That's the only way I can get a fresh start. I got married and divorced in California. So I ended up having to pay alimony. Yeah. Until the day he dies. Yeah. And he's dating another divorcee that has the same situation. If either of them get married, they lose their, you know, their alimony. So now, after the divorce, I can't be left alone. I need company 24/7. In case something happened to my ex, I need solid alibi. So I am so used to working in front of a quiet audience. You make noise? I just figured the anesthesia failed. And right around now, I'll ask my anesthesiologist behind me to pass gas. Anesthetic gas, nitrous oxide, laughing gas. And I don't have to work so hard, make jokes, tell funny things. I'll have all of you rolling on floor laughing. I'm Dr. Peggy Ching. Thank you so much.
Give it up for Dr. Peggy. True story, Dr. Peggy. Next week for my surgery, I know the anesthesiologist, and he is an actual amateur comedian. He tried it professionally, didn't work. He and I started, I've been doing comedy 15 years, we started about the same year. And he did my anesthesia, he was in one of my other surgeries a few years ago, and I told him, I said, listen, Dr. Wayne, the only way you're gonna put me out is if you tell me your jokes. And I woke up from surgery, I was having surgery on my right foot, I had a table fall on it, I woke up, and the physician, you know, it's all bandaged, and he goes, hey, Wayne, no problem. Had no problem taking half the foot off. And I was like, I thought you were just going to drill a hole in there and mess with it. And he was like, oh, no, sorry, I got the whole half of the foot. And I was like, oh. And he was like, yeah, Dr. Wayne and I are good friends. Gotcha. So, yeah, never mess with the anesthesiologist or the doctor. Don't be a wiseacre with the doctor either, because you don't want to tick them off. Please welcome our next performer. Glad to have her back. I haven't seen her in a few months or, I don't know, it seems like forever. But I really enjoy her music. You'll enjoy it too. Give it up for Donna Landry.
No. I'm not in the witness protection program. Hi, I'm Donna. It's a Grace Potter tune. Strange the This is one you probably know, so feel free to sing along if you know it. Song. This is an L. King.
Warm in the winter, left and frozen in the spring. Bye bye. By the seas.
One, two, three, they're gonna run back to me. They always wanna come, but they never wanna leave my head.
Mike, you're fired when I come back. I'm kidding.
Let's hear it for Wayne for doing this.
Yeah.
He's an awesome guy.
This is awesome. This is like one of my, this to me is not even a job. This is just super duper fun. Get up for Donna Landry. Please welcome our next performers, yes. Stacy and Steve, new to the Brew House Gallery. Give it up for Stacy and Steve.
Just like that. Good evening.
Good evening.
Now, I'd like to thank also Wayne. This is a nice thing he's got here. This is super eclectic. Some of you that might have been to some of the coffee houses in the 60s or the 70s, this might give you a little reminisce of that. How's the preamp, Mike? Okay? This is a Texas song. This is my friend Stacy. This is a Texas songwriter from Houston, a guy by the name of Shake Russell. This is called Deep in the West. Yours, take me some time, here I go. guy by the name of Shake Russell has been around Houston, Texas a long time. So anybody here from the 60s? Raise your hands. This gentleman over here, maybe? Scared to raise your hand, yeah, okay. This is a great old song by Stephen Stills. It's kind of our spin on it. This is the old acoustic version of the song you'll recognize. It's not the band version. This is called, If You Can't Be With the One You Love, Love the One You're With. Center about a month ago. That's hand signals for I'd like to have some of my beer. Thank you very much. My lovely wife. We're Stacy and Steve again. Thank you so much, Wayne, for giving us an opportunity. This is a super cool place. This is a fun place. You got a full house. This is one of your favorite bands, I think you told me about earlier. We're gonna feature Stacy on this one.
goodbye. I know you really want to be your own girl. Maybe you can never look me in the eye. Can you buckle with the weight of the world? Stop dragging my, stop dragging my, stop dragging my heart around. Stop dragging my heart around. Stop dragging my heart around.
Thank you very much, Tom Petty. Stacy, I'm Steve. Thank you very much. Wayne, thank you. Mic down?
All right. Surprise, tell people that.
Thank you, man.
No problem.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. My wife's older. She's a cougar. She's a year and 13 days older. Everybody's like, that's not a cougar. I'm like, I tell her every day, you're a cougar, baby. But I love her. We're going to switch things up a little bit. Please welcome our next performer to do some comedy for you. Give it for Brian Manning.
Wow, wow. Brew House, how are we doing tonight? So, give it up for Stacy and Steve. Weren't they great? I think they said they were from either Texas or the 60s. I'm not sure. What is that? That music was really groovy. Dr. Peggy was on earlier. She was great, really good stuff. She was trying to tell me some jokes earlier, and she goes, this will cause extremely contagious laughter, but she said it in a very medical kind of way, like bio-level 4 kind of laughter. I don't know. I might need some gloves, and I don't know. And then the second performer, she don't want to say her name because she said she was in the witness protection program, and that's exactly, she said she wasn't in it, and that's exactly what somebody would say if they were in it. So I'm just trying to keep things, you know, confidential. But anyways, my name's Brian, and I just moved to Florida not that long ago. I'm originally from Springfield, Massachusetts. If anybody doesn't know where that is, that's this little city that's right outside Boston. But now I moved down to Palm Beach Gardens, and that's also outside Boston. Basically, everywhere in the world is outside Boston, except Boston. Checkmate, Boston. And it's good to be outside Boston, because Boston is all about, Oh, what kind of team are you into? Are you into Red Sox, Celtics, Bruins, Patriots? It's too imperialistic up in New England with their football teams. The Patriots has like 5 states. Florida has 3 football teams to the state. Is that weird to anybody else? I don't know. Oh, jeez. But, I'm trying to do stand-up, and that's kind of like selling jokes. And I was trying to sell some jokes to an audience the other night, but they were like kind of like Craigslist customers. I tried to like deliver a joke, and they were like, "I'll give you a ha and a half." Yeah, that one didn't sell either. You see some weird things down in Florida, and I just went to that place down the road, Laxamachi, Latsatachi, Lots of words, I don't know. And I went out there, and that's really country area Florida. And I went to this spot, and there's like this compound with these dogs, and all these like 30-year-olds have these dogs, and they like to talk about how dogs are way better than children. Amongst all of us, they're like, oh yeah, I can't wait till these dogs grow up. I wonder what they're gonna be like then. But dogs, we have to remember, they're kind of like animals that all of a sudden it became like earthquake season, that something riled up in these dogs, and some of them just started going at it. And everybody resorted to caveman mode, like the women ran away, and some of the guys stepped forward. They were like, must stop. And me, I took a step back and I was like, eat the winner, eat the winner. That's right. I come from ancestors of assholes. Didn't I say it was outside Boston? Yeah, bringing it back. I might talk about some, speaking of assholes, I might talk about some political stuff. I was hearing this stuff in the news about the president having had sex with the porn star Stormy Daniels. And it's crazy that we made it out of this recent hurricane season. If this guy has sex with somebody named Stormy Daniels, what is he going to do when Hurricane Florence comes up to the U.S.? He's going to be like, can she keep a secret? Yeah. Oh, man. Nah, I don't know. And I was some international news. You know, Britain, they just had this vote in Parliament that you can vote out the prime minister. That's like the president. It's called a no-confidence vote. We almost need something like that in the U.S., but we can't call it no confidence. It would be like a no thank you vote, or maybe with this president, we'd have to call it the no means no vote. Or maybe with this guy, we just gotta say, you're fired. That's the only thing that will get through to him. Oh man, what is this? Oh yeah, you know, I'm single right now, and yeah, I was dating somebody not that long ago. She was born in mainland China and just moved over to the United States like 4 years ago. And she was still learning English. And, you know, the relationship didn't work out. And I should have known right away. Like, the red flags were everywhere. Just look at the country. And geography lesson. And you know, like, the language between us, that was a big barrier. You might say it was a great wall or something. And we would we would text message one another with like text messages that would almost read like fortune cookies. Like one time she would send me this one message saying, you cannot wear your black hat. And that would usually mean I'm being an asshole. And then sometimes she would say, we cannot enter the same river twice. And that would mean we can't do date night at Hooters again. And then sometimes she would say, lucky numbers 296-419. And that usually meant that it wasn't just the numbers getting lucky that night. Yeah. Oh man. I think I'm gonna bite the bullet this year and finally do it and sign up for 23andMe. And, you know, I did it once before and I was banned because I was nervous about sending in my DNA. So instead of sending in my hair sample, I took a hair sample from my cat and sent that in the mail. They wrote back to me, you're a pussy. And I was impressed. I'm like, wow, maybe they got something here. So I sent in another hair sample, but they were kind of tired of me. They wrote back, you're a dick. And I go, close. I wrote that back. And then they finally wrote me back again and they said, you're nuts. And I wrote back, you're absolutely right. I don't think I'm gonna know what my chromosome count is any day. But yeah, I think that's my time. You guys been a great audience. Thank you very much. Give it up for Wayne and the other performers.
I don't think I got it.
Give it up for Brian Manning.
Yeah.
Here. Brian, like, when you kiss your Chinese girlfriend, like 10 seconds later, do you want to kiss her again? No, you say you eat Chinese food, 10 seconds later, you're hungry. Hey, they can't all be funny. Some jokes are just for me, folks. Some are just for me. Please welcome our next performer. Back again. Second time up? Make him feel welcome. Give it up for Joe Magoo.
Hello. How's everybody doing?
Good.
All right. Good crowd. All right. Well, I've been just doing this for a short while, so got a few things I'll throw out there and see what everybody thinks. So anyways, I was talking to my mother the other day on the phone, and we were just chatting, and I was telling her, you know, Ma, I've been thinking about something for a long time, and, you know, I think I should, you know, just come out and tell you. And she was like, oh, finally, I'm going to find out why I don't have grandkids. And I go, I don't really see how that's related. But anyways, so I've been thinking about trying to be a stand-up comedian. And she goes, oh, not what I was thinking at all. But still explains why I don't have any grandkids. So actually, I'm a chef. And being a chef, you work with a lot of people that speak Spanish. You learn kind of kitchen Spanish. It's not exactly the same as what you learn in school, but it gets you by. And right when I started working in kitchens, I got one nickname, and they would call me Pato Sucio. And I'm like, oh, what's that mean? They're like, oh, kind of like a badass. And I'm like, all right, great, great. So I go in, I'm telling a few of my bilingual friends, and they're like, what? Bro, that means dirty fag. And I'm like, oh, man, freaking pendejos, right? So then I got a little bit more confident, started learning a little bit more Spanish. I'm like, talking to one of the guys, I'm like, hey, ayúdame, chupa 20 huevos. And he goes, what do you think you just said? And I was like, oh, just help me crack 20 eggs. And he goes, no, you just asked me to help you suck 20 balls. I'm like, oh man, these freaking pendejos, man. But anyways, so then you come into across some other guys that they don't speak any English at all. And you try to throw together some stuff and like some words, get them to like help you along and whatever. But you make one mistake on their paycheck and all of a sudden they become an accountant. And it's like, Bobby, right here. If you notice on line 4 here, you're not taking enough deductions. So at the end of the year, I'm going to have to pay out. And all of a sudden you're like, wait a minute, I thought you didn't know any English. Anyways, and then also being a chef, you come across a lot of like food porn is like the big name for it now. All the like pictures of food online, and people are really starting to like compromise the quality of the food almost to make better pictures. It seems where you know, we're all worried about like underage photography and underage like pictures online, but nobody's really worried about like these fruits and vegetables being picked way before their ripeness, just for that bright, pretty color. You know, that bright red tomato looks great, but it's not ready yet. From like brown, bananas are supposed to be a little bit brown, some spots, whatnot. That's when you know they're good. I've even heard it put, the browner it is, the sweeter it tastes. But I actually read that on Tinder, on somebody's somebody's profile there. But those Tinder and all those online dating things are awful, just awful. yeah, I've gone on a couple dates, so bad, not even worth mentioning. So just glaze past them. My only luck on there is pretty bad. That's how I'd explain it. But anyways, I did have one encounter that was pretty good. Beautiful girl, we ended up hitting it off well. Head back to her place, getting a little bit hot and heavy, start kissing, start whatever. She's got a beautiful body, nice silicone. Anyways, so I start working my way down, and I go, wait a minute, that's not what I was expecting to find at all. Excuse myself for a second, ran to the bathroom. She goes, oh, sorry, I should have told you. She's pretty well endowed for a pretty lady. So I splash my face, look in the mirror, and go, wow, this is intense. Spent a lot of time perusing porn, but wasn't quite ready for this. But I must say, I could say unbiasedly, it's not that bad looking. So, splash my face, go, you know, it's been a while. Let's do it. I look in the mirror and I think, might have to call my mom and update what I was coming out about. But anyways, that's my time. Hasta la pasta.
Do we? good for Joe Magoo. Please welcome our next performer. He is one half of the Moon Men, who will be playing here on the 23rd, Sunday the 23rd. I know it's a couple days before Christmas. We're going to be doing some live music. Maybe the guys leaving throwing some Christmas music. The Moon Men will be playing Dominic Delaney, who you'll see later. And we're also going to be raising some money for Salty Dog Paddle for their dog rescue. So come on out. It's free. Hang out. Grab some beers. Throw some money towards the dog rescue, help the little puppies, because we all like puppies, don't we? Yeah. Does anybody not? Just show hands. If you don't, just admit it. Anybody not like dogs? All right, cool, because this is a very dog-friendly place. Okay. And we love dogs here. But please welcome Devin from the Moon Men. Yeah. I wasn't sure it might be like Moon Men, but then it's only one. So I just said Devin from the Moon Men.
Actually, I go as Bowie Danger now, by the way.
The Lone Booner.
Okay, this is going to take a second. As Wayne said, December 23rd, we'll be playing some tunes. We'll hopefully have the trio out, or possibly a four-piece for the Moon Men. We vary in size. But I'll play a couple songs here. This one's called The Sun Comes Home. To Ireland, and we stole a couple of his songs, so this is one of them called Sable.
Feel the shackles. I'm gonna be the best.
Sable Bar, one of our founding members, Johnny Griffin. And without a bass player or mandolin player, I'm going to attempt the song.
In a rose tattoo, got your name written in hair in a rose tattoo.
Christmas Eve Eve. Us the Moon Man and Dominic Delaney. He'll be up in a little bit.
Woo. Give it up for Half Moon.
Woo.
His band used to be called Holden the Moon because he and his brother's last name is Holden. And one night I said, we should call him Holden the Moon. They started using that. And then when I told them that they had to start paying me 20% royalty, they changed their name. So if you use Half Moon, it's really kind of copyrighted. Like, I came up with that. All of a sudden I see a page go up on Facebook, Half Moon.
Where'd you at?
Or if you go by Devin Holden.
Yeah.
I said it.
Okay.
All right. I need the money because I really want those drop. Oh, rent the tickets. Mm. Oh, did I say that? Yeah.
I'm fighting you for those.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, that was a little flash. That was a little callback to the song that you just did. Dropkick Murphys are coming in. So if you guys all wanted to chip in like $20 and buy me tickets, that's what I want for Christmas. That and Rolling Stones tickets. Because unlike some people, I didn't get to go to England. This young lady over here for her birthday went to England and saw the Rolling Stones.
Yes, sir.
And didn't take me.
Didn't take you, and I was happy to be by myself.
I know. Typical. Let me give it up again for Devin, Half Moon, whatever he's calling himself tonight. Please welcome our next performer, our youngest performer here this evening. Give it up for Royce Emily.
I'm 77 years young, and I keep having to prove that I don't have Alzheimer's by giving you my welcome. My name is Royce. I'm also known as Royce by choice, but that's because I talk in rhyme. I seem to do it all the time, and I feel fine, but everyone else, well, they seem to think it's a crime. My Afro-American friends think I'm talking rap, but I've told them that's a bunch of crap. They say if you talk in rhyme, then you're a sap. And I've tried to explain, look, I'm just an English chap who loops to rhyme when I get the chance, since my body no longer lets me dance. Words choke and fog my mind from knowing time. Then I start talking to everyone in rhyme. Some of my friends think I sound like Dr. Seuss, but I swear I don't like green eggs, ham, or juice. I'm just a simpleton who thinks with his heart, hoping my words will make me sound smart. Not schooled to write in proper verse, spelling and grammar, well, they've been my life's curse. But on I go looking for the truth, and all that I'm sure of is I've lost my youth. Well, for a little while, I'll try and make you smile. I'm really glad that you're here drinking all the brewhouse beer, but you better order another beer. I may end up sounding rather queer. Well, I came here to do some stand-up, but I didn't memorize my jokes, and being my brain is old, I'll have to read them to you. I'm glad it's not late, because last week, oh well, I fell asleep. It's almost past my bedtime. I'm so old that I can remember when air was dirty and sex was clean. I'm so old that my blood type has been discontinued. Being that it's the 13th today, I started out unlucky when the button on my shirt fell off, and then I picked up my briefcase and the handle fell off. Now I'm scared to go to the bathroom. I was in a store the other day, and two guys ahead of me at the checkout were talking in Farsi. I asked why they were talking in Farsi, that they were now in America and should be speaking Spanish. I know I'm old when I'm the only one who remembers the championship fights between two white guys. I've been married three times. I have so many wives that my son thinks I'm a bigamist, you know. In my day, only women had sex. And if you wanted some, you had to get it from a woman. This past election was tough. It was like selecting which street mime to watch and listen to. When a salesman tries to sell me something and tells me it's an investment in the future, I usually tell him I'm so old I don't even buy green bananas. When I started having sex, safe sex meant moving the headboard away from the wall so you didn't hurt your head. I wear what I'm told to wear by my wife. After being married 3 times, I'm well supervised. I know my second marriage was not going to work out. On my wedding day, when she showed up at the wedding with a date. If you want my final opinion on the mystery of life and all that stuff, I can sum it up like this. The universe is like a safe, and the combination is locked up in that safe. Thank you. Good night.
For Roy Zimley. Royce, I got one for you. Royce is so old, his social security number is in Sanskrit. You can have that. I wrote that for a comic years ago, and he's since passed on. London Lee, who was the first comic, he was on the Ed Sullivan show with the Beatles. I got to do a show with him one night, and he was on stage, and it was a few months before he passed away. He was really old and frail. And I opened for him, and about every 10 minutes he would get off his stool, and then he didn't have the energy to get back on. Wayne, are you still here? I go, yeah, I'm back here. He goes, I need help back on the stool, so I'd have to go up on the stage at the comedy club and help him on the stool. And so he wrote a fat joke while he was on stage, and he was like, Wayne, you can have this joke because you're fat. So then I wrote the old guy joke about the Sanskrit thing, and he kept using that. But he said, when I die, you can give it to somebody else. So you can have that.
Thank
but
you.
Please don't die. We don't need anybody dying at our open mic. We had somebody last year have a heart attack in the middle of it. We had an artist up here performing, and his music was really good, and all of a sudden he stopped, and I'm like, what? He never freezes on stage. And a guy was having a heart attack in the audience. It was crazy. Some of you guys remember that. I was like, all right, what do I do? And then like Jeff Tate was up here performing. He's like, do I stop? Do I keep going? I'm like, just stop. Hold on. But anyway, enough of me. I'm on drugs. I'm on a lot of drugs in preparation for surgery, so some things I might say just are stupid. I don't know where our next performer is. I hope he's still here. I don't see him. Please welcome Waldo.
All right, well, start off the show with, I forgot what I was going to start the show off with, but, that's right, I'm going to get, snapping my fingers, it's like almost like ADD with me, I've uncovered some money where I can get a new tattoo. And the thing with tattoos, first things first, location, real estate-wise, you know? And then, I heard this joke, getting a tattoo on your arm is questioning the type of job you want. And getting one on your face is, you've given up. And then I'm like, in order to get a job, it's like, I don't think a tattoo would be hold any waiver over whether I get a job or not. I think it's really, my mouth would really deter me from getting a job because I'm too brutally honest and blunt, too straightforward. I call things how it is. Kind of makes me a bit of a douche too, but semantics. What else was I gonna talk about? Oh, again with that snapping. I uncovered at a bar like this that was a way to kill two birds with one stone. I saw a pretty girl with a tattoo above her rack, and I was like, you can kill two birds with one stone that way. Like, I love comic books and I love motorboating. So you can motorboat and like almost read a comic book simultaneously. Delightful, right? No, well, not for any women, unfortunately, if you're straight. What else did I have kicking the free? I talked about that, a tattoo, and, oh, since I'm, yeah, that was my Casanova, me, my lit leg of being a Casanova, and next was at that bar, I saw that girl with the interesting tattoo. This girl, she was a lot younger than me, but she hadn't been of age in order to drink, but she had this tank top on. She was a real looker. I mean, she I would be like a 5 and she'd be a 10. Yeah, she was good, that good looking. So chances of her personally being all that enlightening would be slim to none. But either way, like, she's wearing a tank top of a band, Slayer, and I was like, man, I saw that band before she was born. And where at that show, where that's where they actually condone child abuse, because at that concert, I got my ass wowed by the Hell's Angels. So then, since I'm on a musical rant presently, you don't see a good, major hitting jazz singers nowadays. Like, there's no Tony Bennett or Frank Sinatra, so he needs to be a Franchilquist singer. Because some of my favorite singers did something abnormal. They added something to the singing. One of my singers was with jazz was Bobby McFerrin. He sung a song, it was a little song I wrote, might want to sing it, fun, no. Don't worry, be happy. And ironically, Robin Williams was in that video. And unfortunately, I had no concept of time, and I have to get going. So I hope you all enjoyed my rant and raving. So until next time.
Give it up for Waldo. We're going to keep the one man themes going tonight. Give it up for our next performer. Give it up for Jason.
In or out, Mike?
Over here?
On the mic stand.
Yeah.
There's two of them. No, in the middle of the mic stand.
No, he's got his own cord.
Yep,
just put it in
the end. So that's, yeah. You gotta plug it in. Volume.
Hey everyone.
Hey Jason.
Hey. I'm gonna start off with some Dave Matthews. Coming here.
come back, reveling in you now. Oh, what if they came down, crushing in a way? I used to plant for all of the loneliness that nobody notices now. Oh, I'm begging slow. Starry night, flaming flowers that brightly blaze, swirling clouds in violet haze, reflecting Vincent's eyes of china blue. Colors changing hue, morning fields of amber grain, weathered faces lined in pain, or soothe beneath the artist's loving hand. Now I understand what you tried to say to me, how you suffered for your sanity, how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now, for they could not love you, but still your love was true. And when no hope was left in sight, on that starry, starry night, you took your life as lovers often do. But I could have told you, Vincent, this world was never meant for one as beautiful as you. Starry, starry night, portraits hung in empty halls,
nameless heads on nameless walls, with eyes that watch the world and can't forget. Like the strangers that you've met. Ragged men in ragged clothes, silver thorn, bloody rose, black crushed and broken on the virgin snow. Now I think I know what you tried to say to me, how you suffered for your sanity, how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they're not listening still. Perhaps they never will.
Yeah. Is that it? We're done?
One more,
please. One more? Yeah. All right, we'll do some Weezer.
Oh yeah, all right, feels good inside. Well, somebody's hiding, it's crowded in my icebox. Somebody's cold one's giving me chills. Guess I'll just close up my eyes. Oh yeah, alright, feels good inside. Flip on the telly, wrestle with Jimmy. Something is bubbling behind my back. The bottle is ready to blow. Say it ain't so. Your drug is a heartbreaker. Say it ain't so. My love is a light taker. I can't confront you, I never could do that which might hurt you. Try to be cool when I say this way is the one that's not away from me, that takes me further every day. Be cool. Say it ain't so.
for Jason. Where else can you find, like, 1 second somebody's playing some Don McLean, next minute playing some Weezer? Please welcome our next performer. His girlfriend just went out the front door to make sure he's ready. Fiance, I'm sorry. Fiance. Give it up for Dominic Delaney. Yeah.
Wayne told me to dress sexy tonight, so I did the best I could. Is there any sound, Michael?
Oh, plug it back in the DI, my fault. I forgot to plug it back in.
Ah!
Sorry, my bad.
All right, so now for the actual stuff that I'm supposed to do. I'm gonna do something crass and start with a new song. I'm leaving Christmas Day to go on an adventure across the country, and it's gonna be super scary, so this is a song about it. It's healed now, so it's okay. And we can all joke about it and laugh about it. But I almost lost my finger, and it was really scary. But I wrote a song about it, and that's what this is about.
Well, I can play my guitar with a broken finger. And I know that that choice might make the pain linger more than it would if I was just a singer. Well, it's me and my guitar and my broken finger. Me and my guitar and my broken finger. The pain comes and goes, it hurts after shows. It hurts in the morning and wherever I go. I don't like painkillers, right now that blows. The doctor said to leave it alone. I can play my guitar with a broken finger. I know that that choice might make the pain linger more than it would if I was just a singer. It's me and my guitar and my broken finger. Me and my guitar and my broken finger. But right now I'm working as hard as I can, but I'm pretty useless without my right hand. And if it looks like I'm giving you the bird, understand, it's got its own mind, yeah, it's got its own plan. I can play my guitar with a broken finger. I know that that choice might make the pain linger more than it would if I was just a singer. But it's me and my guitar and my broken finger. Me and my guitar and my broken finger. I'm honestly lucky that my finger's not gone. Well, it was crushed by the weight of the world and mother-in-laws. Well, I think that it's time to move on. Well, a prescription for Jameson is all that I need. If I had extra money, I'd get some fire-ass weed. Well, thank you, my friends, for coming to see what my broken finger has done to me. What my broken finger has done to me. But I can play my guitar with a broken finger. I know that that choice.
Let's steal a couple more seconds and just say, this song is about my childhood house, and I had an apartment as an adult, which I am still, I'm still an adult, but I had an apartment, I don't have it anymore, and in between this little time of where I stay now and not having my apartment, I squatted at my childhood home, which was kind of a really weird experience. It was kind of enlightening in a way, but anyway, I have a song about it, and you're gonna have to listen to it, because I have a microphone. I cried my eyes out the first night in this house. I was a child and I didn't want to move. I had friends there, maybe somewhere. Hopefully I'll find some new ones soon. Those were the 90s, they're far behind me. I even don't a pair of that barn shoes. Spit on preachers, I pissed off my teachers, and I even got caught buying weed at school. And I cried my eyes out that night in this house. I'm a teenager, I don't know what to do. I had a family, y'all know I'm rambling. Well, that's probably a symptom of the few. And I'm back now, there's mold on the walls. This house doesn't seem so tall. Actually a true story. The last hurricane that we had completely caved in where I would have been sleeping, and I'm really dumb and I wanted to stay during the storm, but my fiance over there made me leave. So I'm alive thanks to her.
cried my eyes out last night in this house. I'm an adult and I don't know what to do. I'm feeling lonely and so my only option is to sing these songs for you. So I'll sing these songs for you. Tonight is show number 121.
Please welcome our next performer. Goes by one name because she's so cool. Give it up for Eden. Just hung it there. Any of the mics. Any of them.
Down. so I leaned over to take it in. As we went hurling over the edge, I started to mend. She looked over me with a part smile. reflection now. I'm sitting on your windowsill.
Kids nowadays, I weep for our future. Give it up again for Eden. Please welcome our next performer of the Brew House Gallery Open Mic. Give it up for Max Seeger.
Hello.
Oh, Max.
Hey.
Maybe this one's more appropriate for the size of my body. Maybe it's this one. I don't know. We'll find out.
All right, what's up, guys? My name is Mac. How's everyone doing?
Woo!
M-A-C-K. That's how you spell it. And the reason I always spell my name, or anytime I meet someone new, I spell my name out. M-A-C-K. Very clear with that. Otherwise, it goes a little something like this. Hi, my name is Mac. It's nice to meet you. Matt! Nice to meet you too. Come on, have some hors d'oeuvres. And so now I have different strategies when I'm introducing myself. For example, if someone approaches me and is like, "Hello, my name is Todd. It's a pleasure to meet you." I'm like, "Hi, my name is Mac, like mac and cheese." But the problem with this approach is now I got people calling me nicknames that should not be calling me nicknames. Okay, that's for sure. They should not. True story. I walk into my therapist's office. She's like, "Hey, Macaroni, take a seat." I'm like, "Karen, can we please?" She's like, "How's the anxiety?"
Always so, Karen. Always a Karen.
Always a Karen. Literally, her name's Karen. So anyway, yeah, this is like my first time doing stand-up, so it is what it is. But this time of year, the holidays, I get some anxiety. It's a special type of anxiety. I don't know if there's a medical term for it. It's called fat anxiety. And I'm just worried that the amount of food that I'm consuming is gonna go straight to the hips, okay? With all the pressure that is surrounding me to eat. Eat your food! It's like, Jesus, Grandma! I'm sorry. Yeah, that was an impersonation of my grandmother. Yeah, that's the original. Did you guys get seconds? Yes, Grandma, we did. This turkey isn't dry at all. Yummy. Meanwhile, you're feeding it to your dog, Mr. Whiskers. Here you go, Mr. Whiskers. Have some beer. Take a seat on the couch and enjoy the game. And that's the cat's name. I know it's a cat's name. So anyway, I'm seeing a therapist. And I'm seeing a therapist for a lot of reasons, okay? You know, like I said, anxiety. But pretty much the main driver, why I got my ass in there, okay, is because of my small penis, okay? And it's hard to cope with, guys. It really is. And recently, I've been on a quest to find people just like me. Sure enough, I hit up the internet, and I find some tight-knit communities. Micromen.org. There's also the South Florida Small Penis Meetup. Oh yeah, you guys ever been on meetup.com? Anyone? Any professional networkers out there? Come on. Anyway, meetup.com is where similar-minded, or in this case, similar-sized, individuals gather to network and share ideas. So I was going to this. I was really enjoying the small penis meetup. Till one day I show up and this guy Dave, he's like, I'm running a little late. He's like, hey, little cock and balls, you're running late. How you doing? Didn't think you were gonna come. And I'm like, oh, I can't come here anymore. I'm like, look, I'll participate in the ridiculous number of Kegels that we do. I will also participate in the comparison session where we all stand in a circle and look at each other's, you know what up, you know what I mean? But I will not be called names. It will not happen. Silly stuff. Hold on, let me see what I got here. Okay, oh, my therapist is actually transitioning to life coach because, yeah, to be honest, I'm trying to kill it. Like, I'm setting goals, and it's that, what is it? It's that time of year, right? Everyone's setting goals, right? Hope you guys got some goals going. And before I had a life coach, I didn't know what the hell, I didn't know how to set goals. Last year I set a goal. I thought it was a good goal. It was look good. That was the goal, look good. Simple, right? Because I thought it encompassed a lot. You know, for example, that could mean you eat better, exercise more, use better filters on Snapchat. You know, come on, it encompasses a lot. So I woke up January 1st, 2018. And I looked in the mirror, I was like, fuck. Oh, excuse me, I apologize for that. I was like, shit, this is not gonna be a good year. 2018, let's put that in the past. let's see. Okay, I got one last one. Okay, so, you know, it's the holidays, right? When watching what you eat is harder than getting a normal water bottle at Fresh Market. Anybody ever been to Fresh Market? It's like a high end, it's a high end place to get some food. It's like a Whole Foods. I was on the way to the gym one day and I forgot my water bottle. I'm like, I don't wanna hook a U-turn. So I pull up into Fresh Market and this lady is pitching me a water bottle with a fan attached to it. I'm like, what the hell am I gonna do with that? She's like, it's good for the environment. If your balls ever get, a little bit too warm, you can cool them off. And so I was like, I'm sorry, ma'am. I gotta go. So I ran away. Found the sole water bottle. I found one water bottle. I was like, perfect. This is it. There was one water bottle that was just normal. And I go to grab it, and boom, soccer mom came out of nowhere. I'm like, holy shit. You know what I mean? She's like, that's mine. I brought it from home. Don't touch, asshole. All right, that's it, guys.
Give it up for Max Seeger. Please welcome our next performer, William Bennett. Okay. Yes, no? Maybe?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, he's good. Give it up for William Bennett.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
My name's William. This is my first time here. I kind of want to be in the middle, so I'm going to adjust this a little bit. I will play some original songs for you tonight, and the first one is called Not a Perfect Hippie. It is an autobiography. I'm going to cut my hair. Too much, and I wanna cut my hair. I put things off until I'm in a rush, and there's nothing left to wear. I drive my car, sometimes real far. I'd like to be alone. No carpool, not for this fool. I prefer it on my own. Not a perfect hippie. Not a perfect hippie, will you still be my food, and I'm sometimes rude, I'm not always aware how the words I say might affect your day when I'm no longer there. Times I fight, I'm not always right, I just want to understand the world I spy, looking through those eyes, please help me comprehend. Wanna be a man, not a perfect hippie, will you still be my company for music festivals. We sell lemonade, pretty much. I found a way to make a living selling lemonade. It's the American dream, right? Well, our company is Just Squeeze Lemonade. We start at Coachella every year, and we sell lemonade for some of the bigger festivals. And I wrote this song on the road. It's called When Life Gives You Lemons. Thank you. Get you lemon to make lemonade. Sell it for mass profit so your bills are getting paid. Life's getting you down, you got nothing to do. Listen up, kid, we got the job for you. Good time because you're here. Couldn't be any better place to be. So I'm going to read you some poems. Anybody here on an app called Facebook? All right, don't admit to it, but I am on this dangerous virus. But I wrote this poem because, you know, hopefully this does go away. So Facebook, where friendships go to die. Facebook, where friendships go to die. Maybe not your friends' friendships, maybe it's just mine. Where profound thoughts are met with a thundering silence when pointing out absurdities and senseless acts of violence. When I cite the impending doom that's coming, that's when my Facebook friends start running. When I share news showing hypocrisy and lies, they say, call me when the revolution is televised. I thought my friends were intellectuals, enjoying a challenging debate. Instead, they post fart jokes while I ponder the world's fate. Maybe I've spent too much time on the information age. I've been on the internet until I got to the last page. But then they created Facebook. Wow, I can share my knowledge about the Freemasons, Illuminati, and uselessness of college. How the CIA created Hollywood, the music industry, and Miley Cyrus. I thought this kind of news would be spreading like a virus.
But nobody wanted to hear it because they were already too invested to test their point of view, which they would rather leave untested. And then there was Farmville, to which I lost my first wife. I think she's still in there, living some farming kind of life. And all those silly games I get invited to each day, like Candy Crush and Pirate Kings. Who's got the time to play? When there is stuff to learn on this information landscape, how British royals perpetuate man-on-boy rape. Maybe it's because I'm 50 and I see my life as half over. I haven't been to China yet or seen the Cliffs of Dover. I see a billion eyes seeking endless entertainment. Too busy to learn the dangers of this universal entrainment that leads us into groupthink, which is not thinking at all, but keeps us in the comfort zone before the giant fall. All I want is the truth. I don't care if it doesn't agree with everything I've thought before it was revealed to me. I'm sure by now I've lost you with all this stuff so serious. I'd better tell a fart joke before you get delirious. But like I said, I'm 50 now. I no longer trust those farts. You never know when one of those will become a random shart. So here's a dirty joke I learned when I was just a kid about some dirty little pigs and the dirty things they did. Two pigs squealed, jumped in the mud, and then they gave a shout. And 9 months later, from out the mud, three little pigs came out. Okay, we're gonna kill Facebook. I'll never read that poem again. Since my son is here, I will read another completed piece of fiction here. It's called My Son is Addicted to Power. I walked into my son's room and what did I see? He's making school posters saying, vote for me. I should have seen it coming. I guess I should have known, but I really didn't expect it from one of my own. It started last year when he joined the student council. I didn't suspect a thing, I just thought he was ill. But there he was, studying, staying after school. Student body president, definitely not cool. I said, son, we are hippies, let live and let live. We're not the takers, we're the ones who give. Spread peace and harmony wherever you go. Tap into the universe and go with the flow. He said, aw, Dad, I won't get rich doing that. I'll start a foundation while my wallet is fat. I just couldn't take it. I pulled out some herb. I said, son, let's smoke a fatty before I get perturbed. Be like your brother. He is high as a kite. You don't see him grabbing for power and might. He said, Dad, peace and love are overrated. I want to live in a neighborhood that is gated. I want a limousine that will drive me to work where I'll get a big fat bonus, he said with a smirk. Say, it's not true. You must be joking. I pulled out my bong and started chain smoking. I couldn't take it any longer. I started to swoon. He's addicted to power. Another Wall Street tycoon. Like, that's what we need. Another hedge fund manager getting high on greed. My own DNA has become a demon seed, plundering the earth to fill his endless needs. Don't go down this path of destruction. It leads to death and destruction. He said, not for me, that's not my dysfunction. I'm heading to Goldman Sachs, where I'll do God's work. I thought, you fucking bastard, really, what a jerk. Sorry about that. He became class president, promised all kinds of shit, and as you can imagine, he delivered none of that. Got a BS in economics and off to Harvard Law, and grabbing millions of bucks with his grubby's little paws, dating a supermodel, shoving cocaine up her nose, and every day his greed just grows and grows and grows. Trading in derivatives and pushing CDOs, counting all his millions on his fingers and his toes. You try to raise your kids right, and this is how it goes. They destroy all humanity. It really freaking blows. Now we've got a new dilemma, a real peach. He just bought us a home on Palm Beach. You know, I love the ocean, and it's got a great surf break. So now I'm on it. I'm a hypocrite. I'm on the take. It would be impolite to turn down this generous gift. I don't want to insult my son and get him pissed. So now we live in luxury, although I really should hate it. It's really kind of nice living in a neighborhood that's gated. There's no moral to the story because I've lost them all. Selling out feels great. We're having a ball. There's no moral to the story. I've lost them all. Selling out, okay. I don't know why I ever cared about the poor and huddled masses. I'll throw him some pocket change, just to help the lower classes. All right. Yeah. So let's, before I even look up to get a flashy, I'm going to see if I can squeeze in one more blog post. Oh, I'm enjoying it so far. I've got 20 of you left, so. Anybody have their job eliminated? They outsourced my job today. For a fraction of what they pay us human types to move our neurons, my useful skill lacked interferon. That's a fancy way to say I wasn't immune to dancing away to the corporate tune. They made a chip that would fit on a pin. That's all it took to do me in. I stand in the back of a mile-long line with other guys that were doing just fine, until they weren't and were served pink papers. They sent in HR to pull off the caper. The CEO bought another house and matched it up with another spouse. The Wall Street Journal called him a hero. He found a new way to add more zeros to the bottom line. That's all that counts. To investors with fat bank accounts. For the corporate slave grinding away, pushing papers in his cubicle each day. It's a scary thought that spooks and frightens. You lose some sleep, your butt cheeks tighten. It's probably time to take back your neurons and generate your own interferon. Interferon, it's a term for immune system to fight cancer and bad stuff that could take you out. I love the telemarketers, don't you? That's what I do for a living, by the way. And very high level, I call it very, very pedigreed people. I love the telemarketers calling me from India. Their number says Ohio, but trust me, they're from India. They say they're from Windows and want to fix my laptop. I say, okay, really? And then I laugh my ass off. They say that they're serious and this is not a joke. I ask, which kind of crack is it that you think I smoke? They want to get my password and stick me with a virus that has more STDs than a twerking Miley Cyrus. They act like they're incensed because I don't buy their shit. And then I start to toy with them and watch them have a fit. I say, I don't have a laptop, I don't even have a phone. I don't know how you reached me, I'm not even home. Do you want to fix my pen? I only write letters. I gave away my laptop to my Irish setters. You can speak with them, I'll get them if you wait. Should be 30 minutes, they went out on a date. They might be with the Johnsons, and if so, they'll hit the bars. And usually, after cocktails, they'll go chasing cars. We can still keep talking, I'm just folding underwear. You haven't said much lately. Hello? Are you still there? I can do this all night, Wayne. So I'll stop right now.
That's what's here. I'm just kidding. Always a pleasure.
Give it up for Jeb Murphy. Please welcome our next performer. Give it up for Diane Holton.
Cold. All right. It must be this one, I would say. Ready? So I heard this song recently that I never heard before by a group called The Water Boys. Did anybody ever hear The Water Boys? I think they're from like Ireland, and this song they did in the 80s. 3, 4, 5. Let's put it up here. So I said, this is a very cool song, so let's see if I can play it. Is this on?
Thank you.
impressionista. Give it up for Diane. Please welcome our final performer of the evening, our headliner for tonight. Give it up for Drew.
Wow, thank you much.
Hello.
Hello.
How's it going, Brewhouse?
Brewhouse.
Awesome. There we go. I had an audition for America's Got Talent on Monday in Tampa. It's my fourth attempt for them, so potentially fourth time will be the charm. They might pull my name out of a hat, Drew. They're going to Hollywood. Yeah, no. Maybe. So, speaking of AGT and all that, you know, capitalist nonsense, I have season tickets to the Dolphins, and I did not attend the game on Sunday. I know, right? AGT took precedence, and I needed to be there and be well rested. However, I'm not usually the most excitable person when it comes to watching football because I'm a Dolphins fan. And they don't give you much to cheer about these days. And I don't let I'm done like always having expectations for them and them breaking my heart. They rip your heart out of your ass. They're very good at doing that. So I'm driving and I'm miraculously in range on State Road 70, and they do the pitches to Still, or throws to Stills, Stills to Parker, Parker to Kenyon Drake. And I almost step on my brake on a wet road on Highway 70 because I could not believe that they pulled that off. Anyway, very exciting anyway. But they've got Minnesota on Sunday, and this is where they were last year, and they lost their final three. So we'll see. Never have high expectations for those teams, for that team ever. Wayne's a Broncos fan. Yeah, but you've also seen three Super Bowls in your lifetime, and they've been to eight. No, they've been to nine, I think. Yeah, so at least you've seen some. We've not. I wonder where else, what other type of nonsense was I going to go? Oh, yes, I saw Beauty and the Beast this evening. That's why I'm performing here so late. And it was an absolutely fabulous show. I would strongly recommend if anybody hasn't seen it, I'm not promoting other venues, but go see it. You guys know where it is. Google and Siri are your friends. Not really. They collect shit on you, but still. Thank you for those laughs, guys. I look very dapper today. I've gotten quite a few, you know, compliments outside, and some people where I was gave me compliments, and all my teachers that I work with and my students gave me compliments today. So I was like, all right, Dapper Drew's in a good mood today. They're bringing, speaking of Beauty and the Beast and Disney, I call Disney the House of Mouse, by the way. We're having a ball at the House of Mouse. Well, I thought that would have went over a little bit better. No, because I can't sing at all worth a damn, which is funny, but I try, strictly for entertainment purposes, you know. They're gonna bring Will Smith, in to play the genie in the new Aladdin movie, and it's just like, I mean, you'll never replace Robin Williams. He's one of my, you know, influences, very, very, very big influences, but why not Dan Castellaneta or someone else who can at least do a marginal job? I mean, I just really can't see Will Smith and draw a connection there. Will's very much, you know, straight out of Bel Air, or he's an iRobot, which that movie got a terrible ratings, but I liked it for some reason. It was a good couple hours to waste when I went and saw it in between my junior and senior year of high school. I don't know. Anyway, I thought that was funny. I actually got to see Shia LaBeouf drop curse words, because I had never seen him drop curse words before that. And it was pretty good. I was like, huh, Shia's got a really bad mouth. Now, I really didn't realize that's actually him in, you know, how he is in real life. He just, you know, yeah. Anyway. Anybody ever seen Disturbia? If you like Shia LaBeouf, awesome, awesome film. Heavily underrated. Loosely based on Hitchcock's Rear Window. Yeah, I'd recommend both of those films, just in case. I'm sorry to sound like kind of like a film snob up here. I really, really, really do. Anyway, let's try this Jim Carrey impression. Hi, I'm looking for Ray Pinkle and a clean pair of shorts. What do you know about Ray Pinkle? Soccer style kicker, graduated from Collier High, June 1976, Stetson University honors graduate, class of 1980, holds two NCAA Division I records, one for most points in a season, one for distance, former nickname the Mule, first and only pro athlete ever to come out of Collier County, and one hell of a model American. Another one of them. Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You another one of them hard copy guys? No, sir. Just a very big Finkel fan. This is my Graceland, sir. And that movie is part of the reason why I know, I'm familiar with the expression, see, the engine's running, but there's nobody behind the wheel. Yeah. And see, I don't know if you guys can tell, I have Asperger syndrome or ASD, and unless you can kind of learn to get over it, a lot of things like expressions like that, especially, you know, you have a tendency, I used to take everything very literal. Things would go way over my head. So for the longest time when I was watching that movie and I would hear that line, I would be like, I don't really know what he means. Oh, there's a light. Anyway, watch The Good Doctor on Mondays. You guys won't regret it. It'll bring a lot of, it'll enlighten you on the disorder. Anyway, Mr. Felber has given me the light. So I'm gonna let you guys out of here on that. I hope you guys have a splendiferous evening. Thank you so very much.
Yeah.
Was that good? I'm with you on that Will Smith thing. I don't see it. Anyway, give it up for Drew. You guys, thanks for coming out. We'll be back next Thursday. I will not see you guys for a few weeks. You guys have a Merry Christmas, Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, whatever you choose to celebrate. All of Kwanzaa, Monica.
You're not here next week?
No, sir. But the rules still apply for you, Drew.
Absolutely.
Because Mrs. Felber will be here next week, and you know she's a hard nose.
I don't swear.
I know. Anyway, you guys have a great night.
You too.